That'll be $19. Pay cabbie. Let's see. I gotta make sure. Ring. Answer phone. Hello? Pick up the telephone. I hear a woman's voice. Hello, Larry. This is Righty. Why don't you forget this silly game and come over to my place so we can finger paint? After all, your skin has always turned me on, so bring along a marbles and come play with my belly button. Bye now. You hang up the telephone and wipe the sweat from your hands. Use phone. All right. 555-8039. Hello, Ajax Liquor Store. We deliver. So what do you want to buy? We need wine. Fine. Where do you want it delivered? Let's see. Honeymoon Suite. Okay, we'll get it right there. Consider it done. Thanks for calling. Click. Now here's another interesting bit of trivia. If you use the phone again, and if you actually have the manual to this game, there's a number you can call to get hints from Sierra. And if you dial that number, you get some points. So I think it's 209-863-8989. I'm sorry, but you have reached a number that is disconnected or no longer in service. Please hang up and dial again. This is a computer. Let's see. I may have the number wrong. It's entirely possible. Let's see. My colors got all screwy. Try a different area code. I think it's 683. 209-683-8989. Please hang up and dial again. Let's see. Well, that's the number it gives me. I'm not sure exactly of the response because I've never done it before. Anyway, whatever. Let's get the hell out of here. What's a casein? Casino. You got it, Mac. Smell like a used fire hydrant. What the hell? That happens frequently. $17. Pay cabbie. Huh. Son of a bitch. You'll not ride with me again. And he kicked my ass. So it happens I didn't have enough money, so I'm gonna have to restore. Now, when was the last time I saved? I think this is about the time we have to go up and... Let's see... $27. We need to play a little bit more slots. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'm going to get back to the part where I've done the wine, and we're on the way back to the casino, so that we don't have to watch it again. So I'll see you guys in a bit. All right, we're back. Actually, I had 27 bucks when I left the casino that first time. Oh, here comes a dog. I don't want the dog. And the cabbie, like, charges, like, a random amount every time you want to go someplace. And this time he actually charged me just enough to make it here or there and back again without actually having to play the slots. But I did it anyway, so whatever. Let's go back up. Got the wine coming. I also determined that I may have picked the wrong opportunity to use that phone number. You might have to do it when you dial the phone the first time, but I'm not entirely positive, so we may miss out on 5 points at the end of the game. Fawn's sexy voice oozes through the door. Oh, baby, it's you. You're back. Oh, man. There's a click as she unlocks the door. Come in, you wonderful hunk. Suddenly you shout, here I come, baby. Oh, Larry, it's you, Fawn says. I thought it was that cute young delivery boy again. You bastard. Pour wine. Carefully remove the bottle from the wine bucket, unscrew the cap, and pour two glasses. She downs her glass immediately. You refill it, and she does it again. Her eyes meet yours, and you're sure luck is with you this time. Oh, yeah. Let's do it again. She says, lie down, Larry. I have a special surprise for you. Then she says, close your eyes, and you do so because you're sure that finally success is at hand. And the big sensor bar. Oh, Fawn, you moan. Oh, baby, that feels so good. Ooh. Say, Fawn, when are you going to get undressed? Apparently they're only censoring me. Hey, what's the deal with the rope? Why are you tying me to the bed? Son of a bitch. When Fawn has you securely tied to the bed, she grabs your wallet, saying, you forgot to pay me for the wine, then heads out the door. You gotta be kidding me. Fawn, come back! You shout, this isn't funny! Although, you may have a different opinion. You wonder if there's any way a guy can consummate by himself. Larry, it looks like the honeymoon's over. Well, son of a bitch. But, luckily, if we check our inventory, we have a pocket knife. Use knife. Somehow, with our hands tied like that. Right, using the pocket knife you got from the old bum by the convenience store, you saw through the ropes holding you to the bed. You grab your wallet and look inside. Oh well, at least she didn't find the 10 bucks you hid in that secret compartment. With your consummate gambling skills, you should be back on your feet in no time. And always remember, when there's a rope to be taken, take it. You never know when a nice piece of rope will come in handy. And let's see, can we take the wine? Grab the bottle and fortify your courage with a long, hard belt. Excellent. Open the door. And the reason you want the rope now and not later is because once you leave, then you lock the door. You close the door behind you and jiggle the knob to confirm it is locked. You can't get back in to take it. You'll see why we'll need it in a little bit. Let's go to one. No sense in waiting. Okay, well, we only got 10 bucks to our name, and that's not going to get us far, so we're going to have to go and do more gambling. You only need really about 50 bucks or so for this last part, but I'm going to go till I get about 100, so I'll see you guys when I'm done. Okay, and we got our money, and now let's go. So now that we've got the rope, we need to get in the taxi again. We got one more thing left to do at Lefty's. Get in. I'm not gonna forget that you kicked my ass. I should take a dump right on your back seat, but I don't think you'd ever know. Get out. Open door. I go back. Here. Knock. Same old guy. Ken sent me. Come on in. Still watching porno. Or what we interpreted to be porno. That would be a wrong assumption to assume that that's exactly what it was. It's probably what it was. I have to walk up those stairs all weird. Okay. Climb out. Time to save. So what you want to do is first tie rope to waist. And then tie rope to railing.